kind of a bit of dirt left on there. There was some dirt left on that stalk. Okay, let's see, we have these okay. Nope, these are fine. It's one of the ones I squished into the drawer, though. I could tell on the back bits off. Can't do it. So those are coming out of the oven. So I went 20, then I went 10, then I went 5. So 35 minutes. Maybe I went 45. I'm not sure. We can always look back and see. I'll put that, and these are just gonna sit just like this. We're gonna turn the oven off. While I finish with the veggies. The celery. We have both onions and the celery all ready to go. I'm not starting it because I have a tendency to start too early and then I'm rushing to cut everything because the pan's hot. So I'm not rushing it today. Wondering what it's gonna get. He knows I'm cooking, but he's not smelling nothing yet. And if not oh, you know what I was supposed to do? Yeah, I need to do that. I don't want to miss out on these, and then have them go bad. Celery doesn't look good in these peppers. That red ones look good. These red ones look good. Yellow ones look good. Orange ones, not so much. I've got a couple of green ones in here that looks good. Wow. last of the snack board leftovers. Salvaged for another meal. I think I have one whole red one as well. I'm going to be using the rest of this one. It's the ones that were in the container. Or this one's not far behind that, that's for sure. So we'll be using it today. So I will be good in the meal. I really only want to go over the cilantro one pass, so I'm going to get it nice and rolled up. And I usually do one pass here, and then I'll do one pass, I'll turn it again and do another pass, and then go once down there. And if you have to do more than that, just make sure you're cutting clean through if you make additional passes. But every pass you make, the board's going to turn green. The greener the board, the less flavor you have left in the cilantro. So one pass if you can. So there's that. Look at that much there. That'll be put into the biscuits and gravy, the gravy. Biscuits and gravy. Forget. I don't want to forget. using chicken bouillon today. Because I have more chicken than I do veggie or beef. Come on, toothpicks, don't fall. I'm supposed to be there. Okay, this is the tomato and the beef. This next one's gotta be a chicken. Nope, it's a beef. Yeah, I got an extra beef there. Chicken. So every bouillon is 2 cups. So I'm gonna take out 2 because we're gonna make about 4 cups. And these can be put back up. Got that toothpick stuck. Well, that's this is where this nasty coffee is. Got this. Tastes like crap. Just so you know. It's $8.50 for that container. It's 8, I believe. But they're like crooked. So you need a special. I cut it open, put it in my machine, and no, not good. Alright, so we need 4 cups of water. So we are going to fill my tea kettle. This will be for the gravy, which we're not cooking quite yet. Alright. Okay. I'm gonna get that little cup of that little bit of cilantro off the board. Because I don't want to accidentally put it in the potatoes. And it's gonna be going into the gravy. Yellow still to put them. This green, because I chopped it 3 times. I got green, I wasted all that flavor, but I'm okay with that. Sometimes you're okay with losing a little flavor. So, and this is just cilantro on the knife, so no big deal. A little bit of cilantro on the other. Potatoes never hurt anybody. Already. Oh no, no, no. I need a little more green in there. More green. Smell and look delicious. So the potatoes have to be basically cooked with love because it's for this quality of hash browns. So, delicious stuff, just so you know. We'll see if we put them all in or not. What different are these than these out there? These I'm not so sure about. I'll use like half of these. Alright. We're done. Onions are done. Start with a little olive oil. Right? Ready for that yet. Butter. Pan on. That'd be a good thing. I'm going to start at 8 and I'll move down from there. Start with 3 cups of water. We need 4. Give it a little more flavor if we don't use 3. Equals 3.5. Hit the 4. I gotta turn my tea kettle on and we'll get a measuring cup for that. These so far are the best ones. They have a soft bottom and I think it's because, I choose to believe, it's because you can measure dry or wet in the same cup with one that has a soft bottom. It is soft. It used to be softer. Okay, so we got that all going. We want to get these veggies in here. So we're going to go ahead and go down. Keep that nicely. Then we're down to about a 5.5 and an 8. Now we're going to go ahead and put these as many as we think we're going to need. So, and we want to use the older ones first. So I'm going to grab these. Get my scales down. I'm getting in the can, and this doesn't look like that much. That's it. Let's not forget the onions. So we're going to use white onions and the potatoes. And let's forget the garlic. The garlic will go in pretty close to the end because it cooks faster. Oh. And we're going to be right on top of the tissue paper. Okay. This going to the hash browns. And yeah, it'll cook with hash browns as well. Just want to get them started. Good. Salt. And pepper in there. Season in layers. This isn't ready for the garlic yet. Garlic cooks really fast. But you want to infuse it as well. You want to make sure the taste is there. But it does cook really fast. And I don't want any dark pieces in my... These are, looks good and started, that's for sure. And the celery will go into the gravy. Do love you. I make it the same way every day. Okay, those look about right. Getting started. Go ahead and put the garlic in, because the garlic is also going to cook with the potatoes, so we'll drop it in there, give it a good mix around, and then we're going to pull the whole thing out. Be incorporated with potatoes. And the heat from the peppers will cook that garlic more. And then they'll cook in with the potatoes as well. And then they will be perfect. Potatoes can take up a lot of oil. They look randomly delicious. Alright, that looks good. I have a medium heat. Potatoes that we baked. Cook this in batches. Nice one level single layer in the pan. If you can mush, not mush, but squeeze a couple of couple more in there.
Good. Fill that whole hole right there.
There you go. So maybe fit a couple more. Just lay in one layer. There we go. All right. Don't touch it. 5 minutes on the clock. I'm going to go 4 because the stove is new. I haven't put this new on the stove yet. So I'm going to go 4 on the clock. All right. We have leftover peppers. We are going to jar those up. All the little ones are being used. I have to wean out the cabinet, maybe. Oh, no, because I had almost, I had a little bit left. Where'd it go?
There it is. Okay.
Not open this yet. I just had to find it. A little bit of paprika. It helps give them color. And it tastes good, too. Unless they're burning, we are not ready to turn it. No, no, they are not burning. So we're going to wait another minute and a half for the return. Did we get the hot water? Okay, I missed that. I got to reheat it. It's fine. Sandwich with a roll. You can just shove stuff in there. Just shove stuff in there. Like a homey roll. Mm-hmm. I close it up. Apple and pepper. Mm-hmm. And now pepper. Okay, so I'm just going to move it over the side. And this is the garlic for the gravy. So I'm going to put the gravy or put it together. Set those aside. Alright, time to turn. Let's see how we do. Oh, almost there. There's some brown. There we go. There's the you single back out as much as you can after turning them. You might have to take a couple that didn't get anything. Any browning on it. Just want to give it a light browning. And turn these ones that need more. Then you're going to take a tablespoon of your pepper. A tablespoon or so. And you're going to sprinkle those up over the top of each batch. So maybe 1.5 tablespoons. 5 minutes on the clock. Just a little bit more. Just a nice little bit. You want to do that. Have enough for every batch. Okay? So now, if you go like this, then you're going to get that nice, even layer. Right. This is for the gravy. Goes in the gravy. Our base is going to be chicken. Base bouillon. We're going to make a roux for the country gravy. And it's amazing. Got onions and celery for the roux. Anything else to go in after? Sausage. When I'm done cooking the potatoes, I'll cook the sausage and all that in a deep dish. Once I get going on this, I can probably start the sausage as well. Turn this one. Starting to brown on that one. See some that aren't brown on one side. Always turn those by hand. So it's a little more even. Right. But don't burn your finger. Use it with a spoon if you want to stick your finger in there. But it's just me and my husband. I don't think he cares if I cook with my fingers. And I'm good with it, so there you go. Just the two of us. And I love to cook. Now, these will stay good for a couple of days as long as you store them right. If you don't store them right, they're going to turn black. And you don't want it to turn black. That's what you don't want, the potatoes to turn black. Not even a little bit. Two more minutes on the clock. You let me know when the timer goes off.
Crisis. She's clearly having issues as well, so now she's resigning.
How long has she been pregnant?
kidding.
I wasn't resigned. I'd be walking out like, booyah, bitches! Catch me if you fucking can, asshole. So, obviously having issues. And all the way down the road, I'd be like this. All the way down the road, I'd be like, all the way past the building, all the way up my car, out the driveway. All right, so 10 seconds left. Now, basically what you want to do with this batch is just toss it a little bit. It's nice and golden brown. So now, I need to make room for the croutons. Uh-oh. A little bit of a disaster, just a tiny one. There we go. We're going to go ahead and put them. Oh, you know what we're going to do? We're not going to do that. All right, so what we're going to do, this one fits in the refrigerator better. So we're going to put the ones right here, right on in that pan. Get everything. Let the pan cool off for a second, maybe. But just give that a minute to cool. We're going to start all over again, brand new batch. Lower the heat on that just a tad. It's still very hot. Oil and the butter mix together. Now we'll start putting potatoes in. Single layer if you can. I got quite a big one right there. Cut that in half. You turn off the oven. It's okay. It was wonky. No. All right. I got enough space for another little scoop. It's right in the middle up there. There we are. I think we can lift those out. There's only a couple that are. They're doubled up. There we go. All right, 5 minutes on the clock. And let me try a taste. Perfect. Well, obviously from adding honey, or I mean salt, they're not perfect. But they're very good. And as the pan is a single layer, I like to put it in this pan in a single layer. So I can get that variety of brownness. Alright. Getting going on the gravy. Gotta cook the sausage and the biscuits and the eggs. Happening. This is all the green pepper I have left. I don't want it to go bad. The longer it sits out, the more it sweats. Okay. And that's why this takes so long. Because you're cooking these, I could have two pans going, but then I'm just back rushing, back and forth, trying to get it all. And this way, you know, you're just paying attention to the one little bit right now. And that's all you gotta do. Just pay attention to the one little bit. I mean, you can do other things, right? But I've already got the garlic cut. I already have the peppers done. I already have the other stuff that's gonna go in the room done. I get to stand here and nibble. They're very good. Perfect. A little bit of crunch, a little bit of softness. Big, huge flavor. Alright. 2 more minutes. Let me know when it goes up. Brown. I'm trying to get all of them left back into a single layer, but all flipped over. I can move them around afterwards. And we're going to add to it. Batches, so two batches. Yeah, that's about right. All right. 5 minutes on the clock. 5 minutes are up. Gonna mix them up a little bit. They look good to me. Start this all over again. I don't know why my lid is on that oil. I'm getting ahead of myself there. I'm going to put in this batch. The other batch is going to be about maybe a little bit smaller than this, even. At least I'm going to get those into a single layer. I didn't turn them very well. I might turn them again here in a little bit. And then we're going to put some peppers in here as well. This one, I hope it's going to be a little dark. And we'll mix those together. That'll be fine. They're good. these seasonings. What do we have? Onions, garlic, and everything else cut. I'm a little ahead of myself here. That's good though. I'm organized now. So we're gonna finish these, and then so we got about maybe 12 or 14 minutes or so, and we're gonna cook the eggs real quick. Those eggs are gonna go in that bowl and wait for the gravy. We'll start the sausage and all that good. And take that out, we'll start the roux and get the gravy going and put the sausage back in. Probably cook the sausage at the same time. That'll get things. This. I'm used to it. I'm used to it. Alright. So, this batch is almost done. I'm going to turn it one more time. It's pretty brown right there. It's pretty brown. I'm just going to let it get a little bit more. Some of this isn't as brown as others. Alright, that looks good. And you have yourself some bomb ass hash browns. And we're going to use this dollop of butter. Oh, I'm going to turn that off. 5 minutes been up. Alright, so now it's the next batch. The next and final batch. This pan will house the whole chicken caboodle. The whole casserole will go into this big dish to be baked. On the clock. Okay. I'm getting impatient. We have about 50 more seconds on the clock. Turn it, add the peppers, another 5 minutes. We'll be done with that. Don't those look beautiful? Those are beautiful. Nice, crispy, potato, not too crispy, but yeah, they're delicious. I'll tell you, tried and true. Not overly done, no starch flavor, peppers are not overbearing. They're beautiful. Could use a little more salt. Turn. go the rest of the peppers. Dishes as you go home makes things so much easier to get food off the dishes, easier to rinse soap off the plate off the dishes. I'm doing them as I go. And if I need them again, they'll be clean and ready to go. Do the biscuits as well. So, a lot of people think that, just put them on top like that. Chicken and biscuit or something. You know?
But that's really not how I like them. I like them
cooked, then I cut them in squares, put them in the whole thing, and then the whole thing goes in. So, I'm just going to dry out these lids and put them on these purple onions are for the gravy. That'd be a nice little change. Or I could use the white ones and use those for something else. Three more minutes on the clock. I'll let you know.